మ్యామ్ స్టార్టెడ్ రికార్డింగ్.
యా థ్యాంక్ యూ.
కళ్యాణ్ మ్యూట్ లో పెట్టాము ఒకసారి.
సో గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ వన్ అండ్ ఆల్. సో వెల్కమ్ టు దిస్ ప్యానల్ డిస్కషన్ ఆన్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్, మ్యాచ్ యువర్ ప్యాషన్, చార్టింగ్ ద రైట్ కెరియర్ చాయిస్. సో టుడే వీ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు హ్యావ్ ద ప్యానల్ డిస్కషన్ రిలేటెడ్ టు Electronics and Communication Engineering Department. These panel discussions are part of the series of panel discussions being held in line with your admissions. So this is basically to give a guidance to all the students and parents regarding the various branches which are available in VNR VJIIT. So as part of this, we have been conducting all the different branches, and today we have the Electronics and Communication Engineering Department as part of this panel discussion. So before I go into the panel discussion, I would just like to introduce the members who are part of this panel discussion. So first I would like to welcome the head of the department, Dr. Y. Padmasai ma'am. So Padmasai ma'am has essayed various roles in various capacities, both at the college level as well as in the various professional chapters like ISTE and IEEE. She has been associated with the department for more than 20 years, and she is currently the dean student progression as well as head of the department of electronics and communications department engineering. I welcome you, ma'am, onto this panel discussion. Next on
thank you, Sudha.
Yeah. Next on the panel discussion, we have Dr. L. Padmashri, ma'am. Our professor in the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, who has been associated with VNR VJIIT for over 23 years. Madam also has been involved in lot of departmental activities like framing academic curriculum and also taking care of the girls' hostel, and in various capacities she has been engaged with the department. I welcome you, ma'am, Padmashri ma'am.
Thank you, madam.
Next on the panel discussion, we have Kalyan Srinivas, who is our placement coordinator in the Department of ECE. He too has been associated with the department since almost like 7 years, and he has been guiding our students of ECE in securing very good placements and pay packages. So I welcome Kalyan onto this panel discussion.
Okay, madam. Good morning, madam. Good morning.
Yeah, good morning, sir. So next in the panel discussion, we have the industry expert, Mr. Avinash Yedlapati, who has more than 17 years of industry experience in the field of VLSI design, verification and implementation. He is currently working for Mirafra Technologies as Senior Director Engineering in the Semiconductor Division, where he is handling the complete engineering delivery and operations at Hyderabad. I welcome you, sir, onto this panel discussion.
Yeah, thank you, madam.
Right. Next we have our alumnus Mr. Rajshekar, who is a 2003 passed out student from VNR VJIIT. He is having 17 years of experience in the embedded industry, majority of it being in the automotive embedded systems and multimedia systems. He is at present leading a team of 30 engineers for telematics applications. I welcome you, Mr. Rajshekar, onto this panel discussion.
Thank you, madam. Thank you.
Yeah. So let us just start up with the general inquiry. I mean, whatever the general inquiries which the students put up, I'll just be asking you one by one. So let me start with the head of the department, Dr. Y. Padmasai, ma'am. Ma'am, many students are basically interested, or they're eager to join this department of ECE. They would just like to know what is this branch all about. Can you briefly tell us what is this branch about, actually?
Afternoon, everyone. I am Dr. Padmasai. Already Sudha mentioned, heading ECE department and Dean Student Progression. It is a great pleasure to welcome you all to this session on engineering education, meet your passion, charting the right career choice. ENR VJIT was established in 1995, and we are very proud to share with you all that this year marks the Silver Jubilee year. ENR VJIT has achieved many milestones. So ENR VJIT is one of the premier institute in the state of Telangana, where many students aspire to join. Electronics and Communication Engineering is most sought after stream by the students. So here in ECE, we are having, so already ours is the Autonomous Institute. We are having various streams of specializations from third year onwards. We are having Communication Stream, VLSI System Design Stream, Embedded Systems, IoT and Networking, AI and Machine Learning. So as for their interested area, students opt one of the streams, they will pursue the streams.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. So now I would like to ask you one more thing related to this branch. Many of the students and parents keep going to various colleges and all. We keep telling that we have NBA accreditation and all these things. So tell us, what is the significance of this accreditation process actually? I mean, why is accreditation important for students?
NBA accreditation is similar to Washington Accord, that is a signatory body that is available at UCA. In India, we are the quality of the programs are, that is not for the institute, it is for only program. It is evaluated, quality of the ECE branch is evaluated, whether the quality of the faculty is available or not. So infrastructure, research and consultancy. So based on that one, committee is visiting the institute and providing MBA to the program. We are fortunate, we are having three programs in the department. All the three programs are accredited by NBA. And UG program, we got four times NBA. Consecutively, we got four times NBA. Recently, in March 2019, we got re-accredited fourth time. So that is the measure of the quality of the institute in terms of academics and research activities. And how we are placing students, based on that one, they will give NBA.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you for that insight about the role of NBA accreditation in the colleges. Now I go to Padmashri ma'am. Padmashri ma'am, being the senior faculty, I would just like to ask you, what are the contemporary thrust areas which come under this branch?
So in modern era, the electronics and communications plays a dominant role in every sphere of our daily life. ECE program specific thrust areas are mobile communications, RF and microwave communications, antenna design, digital VLSI design and optimization, signal processing, and embedded systems. The other thrust areas where ECE reflects the dominant influence in adding value to design systems, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, machine learning, robotics, and intelligent systems. So these are the main thrust areas in ECE department.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, by giving us an insight about the thrust areas. Similarly, what is the skill set expected out of the students coming out of this branch, ma'am?
So generally, the student aspire to work in industry and pursue higher education in acclaimed universities in the world. The quality and quantity of skills plays a dominant role to achieve these two major opportunities. Towards this, we encourage the students to strengthen the required skills. Some of those skills are mastery of the core knowledge, and ECE specific tools are design of electronic systems by using Synopsys, multi-SIM, Proteus softwares, so on. For embedded systems, Arduino IDE and Keil software, etc. For electromagnetic applications, HFSS and ARIES software, the tools for technical computation and visualization for example, those are MATLAB, technical skills, analytical and problem solving, communication skills, interpersonal skills. It is preferable all ECE students should have to familiar with all specific tools, but make an effort to gain expertise at least few of these above mentioned skills depending on their interested field of the student.
Okay, ma'am. So very good to know that we have lot of exposure given to the students and lot of skill set, as you told, which has to be maintained by the, which has to be acquired by the students during their course in the college. So I think the college, the department has very good licensed softwares probably which are being used for training up these students. Thank you, ma'am. And I'll just get back to Kalyan, our placement coordinator. Kalyan, I would just like to know what kind of jobs are there for ECE students generally?
Generally means, ma'am, actually we have jobs like if you consider public sector units, so we have so many defense research laboratories are there, as well as space research centers are there, like ISRO, National Remote Sensing Center, National Atmospheric Research Laboratory, DRDL, DRDO, MTRDC. These are the various opportunities for ECE, exclusively for ECE students only, ma'am.
Okay. Sir, similarly, who are the major recruiters, especially related to the ECE domain?
Okay, ma'am. Coming to major recruiters, with respect to ECE department, we have, like coming to bulk recruitment partners, we have TCS, Capgemini, LTI. These are the bulk recruitment partners for ECE. That means, for example, every year they used to hire, for example, if you, according to 2020 statistics, out of 240 students, 150 students were hired by TCS and 90 students were hired by Capgemini. And remaining students were hired by L&T Infotech. The beauty of VNR ECE placements is we are giving couple of chances to ECE students until they get the good package. For suppose, if a student got selected for TCS with the 4.5 lakh per annum, later after TCS, if Deloitte came with the 7.6 package, definitely for TCS selected student also, we will give one more chance. And our annual average annual package is 4.5 lakhs and our maximum package is 41.2 lakhs, ma'am.
Right, right. Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving us those statistics also related to the pay packages. I'll just move on to our industry expert, Mr. Avinash. Sir, I would like to know what are the scope of opportunities that ECE students have? Since you being in the industry, so can you just give us some inputs about that?
So definitely, madam. So first of all, I would like to congratulate Padmasai madam and her team for molding VNR VJIT into a hardcore VLSI institute for ECE. So where there are so many core jobs, and you know, it has a brand of its own, VNR VJIT, as far as I know. So there are a lot of VLSI students whom I have spoken to in the past who are from VNR VJIT, and they are actually doing a lot of VLSI work or actual core work in the industries. So congratulations to all of you at the beginning. So coming to the opportunities, there are endless opportunities for ECE students. In fact, I would congratulate each person who has actually chosen ECE over CSE, because ECE has a blend of both computer science as well as electronics. So that is a very rare combination. So people who are generally choosing CSE, they are limited to computer science. But people who choose ECE actually have a blend of both operating systems as well as computer programming and as well as hardware languages like Verilog or VHDL. So there are a lot of opportunities for ECE. In fact, I have a slide to share. I don't know how to share this, but I have some information which I wanted to share. Is it possible that I can share it?
Definitely, sir. We can do it. So if you look at your meeting tab in the down, you can find present now.
Okay, madam. So, So there is just one slide which I wanted to actually show.
Sir, it's okay. You can even mail one of our spocks. They can present it, sir. It's no issue at all.
Just a minute, ma'am. Just a minute. Yeah. Are you able to see, madam?
Not yet, sir.
Okay. Actually, I have already
shared. Yeah. I think it's
sharing. Yeah, now it is coming, sir.
Okay. So, madam, this is actually a McKinsey report which was recently published in our company. So, as you know, due to this pandemic, it has been a lot of industries were affected. In fact, you know, a lot of layoffs have happened, and a lot of damage has happened to employees and both employers as well. But if you see this McKinsey report recently, so semiconductors is actually doing extremely well even during this pandemic session. So in fact, the beauty of semiconductors is that it has beaten pharmaceuticals, which is supposed to be doing very well during this pandemic, right? There are a lot of medicines, lot of patients, you know, getting treatment. But semiconductors has actually beaten pharmaceuticals, and which is itself a very good sign of how the industry is moving even during the pandemic, time. So I would say that VLSI and other core technologies like embedded and programming, everything is doing very well, extremely even during these hard times. In fact, there's a lot of recruitment also, as your placement coordinator was saying, there is a lot of recruitment also happening, and the salaries are also have not been affected at all. In fact, people are getting very good salaries, especially even experienced people, and it is being doing very, very good, madam. The semiconductor industry is in fact doing very, very well, as you can see from this report. So first is semiconductor, second is pharmaceuticals, third is personal products, and fourth is software. So this is the ranking which McKinsey has, a very top analytical firm, which has given the ratings for different industries during this pandemic. This is what I want.
Right, sir. It's very, really very interesting to know about the statistics which you have projected right now, sir. It clearly gives us an edge, telling that we see people do have a lot of scope in varied fields of engineering. Thank you, sir. Next, I would like to go to our alumni, Mr. Rajshekar, sir. Mr. Rajshekar, I would just like to know what is your branch relevance to the present job, whatever you are doing, sir? I mean, how do you connect it actually?
Good afternoon, all. So first, I would like to congratulate Padma Sai madam and the team to organize such a big event, so that in our times there was no proper guidance to choose which branch and all. So I accidentally chose an electronics and communication branch, but really I'm enjoying that branch results till now in my career. So I would like to tell you one thing. Generally, software is an industry where it goes with ups and downs. Whereas embedded systems and electronics engineer, this industry will not go to ups and downs based on the trend. So I would like to inform that whatever I have learned in the electronics and communications, I am currently using in my product development. Basically, we are working on some audio video navigation systems for one of Indian OEM, wherein we do the hardware design, and we work on the communication side, modem side, we work on that. We work on the microprocessor level and controller level, and we work with DDRAM and SDRAM memory types. All these things, whatever I have learned in my college, and now also I will continuously brush up my electronic basics. This is very important. And we predominantly code on C language, and if it is hardware dependent, we will code on C language, and application programming we do in C++ and Java. Not only programming languages, when you take the operating system, whatever the operating system we studied, still it is very useful. We work on Android and Linux operating systems to develop a complicated products in our industry. So this is my awareness of the electronics and communication branch. I would like to tell you one thing. In electronics, you have electron, neutron, and proton. somewhere I read these are three linked with Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara. So these three things, without these three avatars, we cannot have anything in the universe. So if you really, if you have some time, you Google it. Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara related to electron, proton and neutron. These are very, very important in our life and to our education career also. Electronics and communication is very, very important. So as madams and sir told, we have lot of opportunities in electronics and communication. And on top of this, we have computer side also programming we can learn and we can do that. So there will be a lot of opportunities in the industry for electronics and communication students. And my personal experience is, in after JNTU, Vignan Jyoti is the best college for electronics and communication branch. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for those very good words which you have put across for the institute also. And I think we can connect to your point that how EC has helped you in your career also. Now I would like to go back to Dr. Padmasai, ma'am. Ma'am, I would just like to know about your department. I mean, what is your student strength, your faculty strength, your infrastructure, your interaction with industries and research projects. So related to this, can you just briefly explain it, tell us, ma'am?
Okay, before going about the department, Rajeshekar and Avinash mentioned the importance of electronics and communication. So even though we are having a pandemic situation also, our industry is all the time it is rising. I always used to tell to the students, always our graph is exponential increase only. We don't have any decay. Okay, so thank you for your valuable information shared to all of us. So coming to our department, so Department of ECE was started with an intake of 60. It has grown by leaps and bounds, and today it caters to the intellectual appetite of 240 EGU students and two PG courses in VLSI and embedded systems. The department, in line with ideology to foster research-oriented learning, hosts a research center recognized by JNTU-H. The major strength of the department is excellent faculty members. So out of that, 14 are doctorates, 15 members have awarded doctorates, 6 professors, 8 associate professors, 46 assistant professors, 35 faculty members in the department are pursuing their PhD. They are at various stages of their PhD program. They have varied domain expertise, catering to the needs of the industry by making their students competent enough with the leading edge technologies. These are the faculty members of the department. Principals are also from the same department. He started his career as associate professor in the department. So afterwards he headed the department of ECE. So he has taken various positions in the institute, presently principal of the institute. All my faculty members of the department. Coming to infrastructure of the department, the laboratories are well equipped in inculcating research culture among the students, besides meeting the stipulated academic requirements. So already Padmasri madam mentioned, Padmasri and Kansuda mentioned, so we are having licensed softwares. So even though we are having pandemic situation, we are having campus-wide license. MATLAB campus-wide license is available. Even the student, they don't have any laptop. So they can use cloud platform directly from MathWorks site. They can work their programs by using even mobile platform also. So instead of downloading entire platform, by using their mobile, whatever the task the teachers are giving, they're able to execute without any problem. And we are having, already Avinash mentioned how we are molding the students to go for VLSI field. So we are having licensed softwares in Mentor Graphics as well as Synopsys. So because of that one, so what, as for the needs of the industry, we are training all the students so that, so when the industry is coming forward to take the students, we are ready with that. All the training programs, as for the needs, we are training in-house. That is one of the advantage at VNR. And these are the some of the hardware equipment facilities that are available in the institute, in the ECE department. In addition to softwares, hardware, some of the hardware, it is not available in all, if you compare, already Avinash mentioned. So compared to in Telangana, after JNTU, VNR is the best. So now we are on par with the government organization. As for the need, we are buying equipment. We are really fortunate, our management, they won't see. It is not for profit society. Whenever we are asking for anything, within no time, they will provide all the hardware also. We are purchasing and we are training all the hardware required as for the industry. These are the, some of the hardware platforms that are available in the department. And not only providing facilities, we are having already all of you are witnessing. So it is not possible by learning from classes. Okay, we have to expose all our students. So because of that one, we are having MOUs with different industries. So these are some of the companies we are having MOU. So, and not only companies, we are having MOU with various universities. So because of that one, any student wants to do any internship or if they want to pursue his master's program, we are giving scope for the, all the students. Sudha?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Thank you for giving that insight about the department, your faculty, your students, and your interaction with the industry. Let me get back to Padmashree, ma'am. Ma'am, can you tell us what are the domains of expertise which your faculty have in the department? That means how? Just tell us about the experienced faculty, whoever are there in the department.
So the domains of expertise of faculty in ECE department are signal processing, RF and microwave communications, wireless communications, VLSI systems, embedded systems, Internet of Things, and machine learning. So coming to experience of the faculty, 50% of the faculty with more than 10 years experience, 10% of the faculty with industrial experience. Most of the faculty of ECE department involved in doing various research projects. Department has quality research publications in journals, approximately 300. Research publications in conferences, around 250. Department encourages to carry out interdisciplinary research projects. Department also organized IEEE international conferences in 2017 with the help of all faculty.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for letting us know that there are various expertise faculty available in the department who probably will be able to cater well to all the needs of the students and as well as the technological advancements that happen in this field. Next, coming to our placement coordinator, Kalyan, can you tell us about how the students are trained for placements and do you involve any experts coming from outside to train the students?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, from second year, first semester onwards, every student of ECE should do one extra course provided by the ECE department as per the current industry trends. We are giving a couple of options to students. They have to choose one course as per their interest. Okay. So we are providing those courses as per the current latest industry trends. And coming to associations, we have very good number of MOUs and we have very good number of associations with the industries. For example, we are doing IoT training in association with the Idea Labs, and we are doing competitive coding skills training in association with the Being Zero. And Being Zero faculty are, they are part of Microsoft. They are working in Microsoft. So like that, we have very good industry rapport we are mentoring. So like that, we are, with the industry help, we are doing trainings for students, ma'am.
Right. Thank you, Kalyan, for telling us about this thing. Now I'd like to go back to our industry expert, Mr. Avinash. Sir, can you tell us what are the thrust areas basically wherein these students can look up to? I mean, what are the things, main research or something going on related to ECs?
So related to EC, as I already told you, the main two thrust areas will be VLSI and the second is embedded. So these two are the thrust areas. For both of them, you need programming skill and you need a very strong digital electronics and especially analog also. There are two, again, in VLSI, there are multiple domains. So since I am in the VLSI field, I can comment on the same thing. So there are multiple domains. Somebody who is interested in analog can go into the analog domain. Somebody who is interested in digital can come into the digital domain. Again, in digital domain, we have a lot of fields like front-end designing, we have back-end designing, physical design or physical design. In analog, again, you have different fields like analog design, analog verification, analog layout. So like that, depending on the candidate's interest, he can choose whatever field he can come to. Typically, more number of jobs are in digital side in India. Because analog is more more of a they consider it more of a complicated subject, and mostly people consider them from IITs. Having said that, there are other university students also who are coming into the analog design domain. But analog layout, there are plenty of opportunities for analog layout both in Hyderabad, in Bangalore and Noida especially. So my suggestion to the students would be to focus on the domain in which they are interested, be it analog or digital. But they have to focus very much on the fundamentals, because during the interview process, we always focus on the fundamentals and we don't expect people to know a lot of things. So if their fundamentals are clear, I think they can get a core job very easily.
Right, sir. Sir, related to the curriculum also, what do you think should be part of the curriculum if the students have to meet up to the industry needs? Think are the essential elements which should be included in the curriculum?
So right now I think Verilog is already a part of the curriculum, but right now we have already moved into the system Verilog. So I think one of the most important thing we can start is probably introduce system Verilog concepts into either final year, because Verilog I think either in second year or third year you might be having, I'm not exactly sure. But you can introduce system Verilog. System Verilog is very much in demand right now. System Verilog plus some IP verification type of thing. So verification is very, very much in demand. Even during the, as I mentioned to you earlier, during the pandemic times also, the two fields which are very much in demand are DFT, physical design. DFT means design for testability, which is again a type of verification. So verification and physical design and functional verification. So these are the things which are very much in demand. Industry is looking for a lot of freshers. We are in fact short by almost 1,75,000 junior fresher engineers. So we need almost those many people to fill the gap. So the positions are plenty. If you people can introduce some verification concepts and subjects like CMOS physical design, I think that will be wonderful.
Right.
So I want to answer Avinash questions. Already, yes. All those we have taken care while framing VLSI M-Tech syllabus. Expert from AMD director is one of the BOS member. We have taken session from that. We are included the system Verilog for PG students.
Okay.
And for UG students also, we are really interested to go for VLSI. The faculty members are giving trainings, providing training so that they don't have any problem. Some of the students from BTech also joined for Synopsys and AMD.
Right,
for 5 years they are working for Synopsys and AMD, sir.
Okay, sure, madam. So I think that is what is expected also. System Verilog is actually the next hardware language which is going to be in demand for a long time. So as you are already doing that, I think that's pretty much. So you are on right path.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am, for telling that these all have been included as part of our curriculum, so which is very good for the students also. So coming to our alumnus, Mr. Rajshekar, sir, I would like to ask you, what are the values that you have learned or that you have carried forward into your life now the, after going out from VNR, I mean, since you are an alumnus of VNR, how has the institute helped you to in evolving actually?
Yeah. So after I passed out, actually, I've tried for masters in US, but because of some reasons, I could not go. So after that, I joined in a very small company, wherein I used to solder the board PCB first. So this is what I've learned in my college days. So in the very first shot, I could do that. So I worked under a very good teacher, like a professor. He is my guru actually. Still now I'm in contact with him. So that is where I got exposed to embedded system, especially microcontroller and a microprocessor. I've learned very much in college. And programming, I was a little bit weak in the college. I could not learn that much. But after joining the industry, I've learned programming. So basically, in my overall job, what we do is we bring up the hardware. So let's say a bare board is given. Let's say we take a chip from AMD or Freescale or somebody, chip vendor. They give us the evaluationary board. And we put the operating system onto it. So in this operating system, whatever I've learned in college, still I refer those concepts like IO, how to do IO mapping, how to do memory management, all these things, OS, how to do a scheduling of a task, how to prioritize the task. So all these things we will design first in the software, then we will put it onto the hardware. And then we will how to boot up the IOs, what is the timing limitations. Not only operating system, we will also work on the real-time operating system. Like you mentioned, Keel, that was the first operating system which I worked in, the real-time operating system. So when we have, when we design a complex system where we have two to three different processors, they will communicate with each other with different techniques. And we recently started working with hypervisor, where multiple sessions will be there, like Linux and any other OS also will be there. So all these things, still I remember those moments, whichever I've learned in my college for operating system and programming language. So that is why I enrich my experience through college and through my work experience.
Right, sir. Thank you for saying this. I mean, remembering all those things way back from 2003 until now, you remember very clearly about IO mapping and all those things. I mean, it's really interesting to know that the foundation had been very strongly given at that level. And I think which is important for any student also joining in EC. Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you for those inputs. Now I'd like to get back to Padmasai ma'am. Ma'am, any kind of research projects which are going in the department, can you just tell us briefly about that? Shall I present it, ma'am?
Padmasai madam, you have to unmute your microphone. It's in mute.
Is my screen visible?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So I am happy to share to all of you. So Department of EC is doing a lot of good work. So we have received 29 projects of worth around 300 crores from various funding projects like DHT, ITRA, CTE, UGC. Okay, department also got patents. One patent is granted, three patents published, and three more patents are filed. So our actually one of the important point here to note down is, so our students are exposed so in various research projects, so that they're having experience in work, a lot of experience in working with faculty member who are pursuing PhD and who are doing research projects. That is added advantages to all of our students. So that whenever they are going for placement, they are able to talk about whatever the technology they have implemented during their project. That is also one of the advantage of ECE department. And one more point I want to tell here. So actually, myself and some of the team members, we started Salicit Technologies. Actually, I got fund from ITRA. So initially, we started collaboration with IIIT Hyderabad. So this is the unique project that is floated by DHT. Initially, in all DHT previously, before that one, only they have to publish papers and finally they have to submit progress report. But at the for this, at the end of the third year, that should be converted as startup. So, I can fortunately share to all of you. So even though we have competed with IITs and NITs, so I proudly say that VNR VJIT, actually we got two projects from ITRA, one in digital healthcare and one in water. So both projects we are able to come up with startups, one in collaboration with HCU and one in collaboration with IIT Hyderabad. This is the only our area is healthcare domain. So we have started Salicit Technologies. Actually, now everybody is talking about COVID-19, but we have predicted the problem this 2 years back. Actually, we started our Salicit Technologies in 2016. We are working on for past 60 years. So actually, we are taking a speech signal from that. We are able to separate any person is suffering with TB, pneumonia, and such diseases. We are able to detect early stage. Okay, so the death rate is very, very high when they are going for a hospital. We want to develop that system and we want to include kept that in remote area. So now we are closely working with Apollo Hyderabad. So that app is already released. In that, a lot of machine learning and deep learning algorithms are developed in that. And one more project, actually, along with us, one of our students, actually, really it is fortunate, no other student, up to now, they didn't get grant from BIREC. That student is very passionate. Generally, in the VNR VJIT, we encourage students, as per their passion, he start doing his projects from second year onwards. We give scope to grow them. So by the time he came to third year, so he also submitted project proposal along with us to BIREC bid. So along with us, he also got 48 lakhs from BIREC bid. He has developed prosthetic hand and he started his own startup in VJ Hub. So that is also one of the feature. And we are having, actually VNR VJIT started VJ Hub incubation cell in the college itself. ECE department, three startups. One faculty members started Salicit Technology, one student started Soulboards, and another MMRFC, this is a Bangalore-based company. They're working on VLSI technology. We have given them space to train our students so that they will get motivated. We encourage students to do projects under them. These are the few sponsored projects received from various funding agencies already mentioned, 29. Okay, we have developed, initially we developed one project, ACTS project, Automatic Commando Training System, that is used in National Police in Hyderabad. At present, they are using that one. That system initially, that is developed during 2007. That time onwards, every time we are looking for problems which our society is facing. We want to solve such problems. We encourage our students as well as faculty to take up such projects. And we thank all funding agencies from DRDO to DHT for supporting faculty members and students for sanctioning these grants.
Right, ma'am. We could see that the department is having a very strong research culture, as can be seen by your projects and by your kind of activities that are going on in the college and in the department. Thank you for that. Similarly, I would like to ask you about the placements. I mean, how are the placements in the, I mean, just a general perspective. Anyway, I'll go into details with the placement coordinator. Just a brief view about who are the major placement companies coming in.
So already Kalyan mentioned about placement. Even though they're coming, whether it may be TCS or Capgemini, all these companies, they're having different verticals. All our students, whoever joined for TCS, they're working on only core ECE. TCS, they're having IoT platform is available, and 5G and LTE technologies, they're working on that. So all ECE student, I can happily say that they're, even though it is software, if you say TCS, all unknown persons, they will think it is software company. But in all software companies also, many of the technologies that are there, suppose if you take LTI, so if you take L&T Metro, so technologies are developed by ECE. For example, if you want to control, you want to check the status of train from one station to another, all those things are handled by ECE engineers, not by software engineers. That is the added advantage of ECE students.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. So we, as you told, the placements are also very, good to hear that we ECE students have excelled in many of the companies, what recruitments had happened. Just in the same line, I would just like to ask you about the academic performance, ma'am. I mean, academic performance of your students. How are the academic performance of the students?
So this also, I am very proud to say that actually VNR is having one unique feature. So every year on August 15th and January 26th, flag hoisting is done by the students, not by some other faculty member or not by principal. It is honored by student, whoever is a topper up to third year. So boy student will do honor of flag hoisting during August 15th. And during January 26th, girl student will do honor of that one. Most of the cases, all ECE student have opportunity to do that honor. And coming to outside, not only inside actually that honor is done comparing to all branches, not only ECE branch. So all the students that are there up to third year, who are the topper of that branch, will be honored. All branches together. So now, so these are the some of the achievements outside VNR. Our students are not only participating in the in-house, they are competing with outside world also. Consecutively four times, our students bagged IST Ideal Student Award, and TCS also encourages Best Student Award. So that also we got consecutively four times. And now, all recruitments and government of Modi government also encouraging hackathons. All our students, not only from ECE branch, from various branches, students are participating in various competitions held by various organizations. They are bringing laurels to the institute. Last year's Smart India Hackathon winners are from ECE department.
Yeah, yes, ma'am. Related to the higher studies also?
Coming to higher studies, not only we encourage for only for placement. Actually, when they are in the campus, we encourage the students, they should have something in their hand. So at the same time, they should not stop for a short-term goal. All the faculty members and our management also encourages, they should not stop after getting short goal. Whatever fashion they're having, by the time they reach 25, they should aim for that. So on that direction, we'll train all of us here. And simultaneously, they will, even though they're having job, simultaneously, they will pursue whatever. Some of the students here, we have listed very few students who have joined for IIM. And some of the students, still they are pursuing. Some of the last year student also get very good rank. And some students, they joined for higher studies at prestigious universities like ours, you know, Columbia universities. And I proud, these are the some of the achievements of passing out of our department. Our recently all these students have joined. Many students after completion of within 1 year, they will go for higher studies. They won't stay. Actually, previously, in final year itself, they will go. Now, because of changes in visa problem, all those things, they're checking whether we should go within 1 year or not. But they're not stopping their passion. They're going and they're pursuing their career and they're achieving that.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you about detailed thing about your students, their achievements, especially in the academic domain. So I could see that the EC students are very strong in their academics. By the way, they have grabbed the awards, especially at the institute level, as well as at the domains where they are competing with other peer groups also. Thank you related to that. Now I'd like to come back to Padmashree ma'am. Ma'am, Padmashree ma'am, I would like to know what are the collaborations with industry that have helped you, your department in one or the other way?
EC department is moving towards excellence through academia and industry collaboration. It enables additional development such as research industries, oriented training programs, exchanging ideas. It also contributes to designing industry-ready curriculum, emphasis on practical-oriented learning, workplace exposure through internships, training programs, sharing knowledge, industrial placements for students, and faculty training programs. ECE department contributes with a number of academic organizations and industries on research and development of projects. The focus of collaboration with industry is to generate new ideas, to create innovative solutions with emphasis on using knowledge in developing practical engineering and technical solutions. In this process, ECE department periodically organizes various guest lectures, workshops, and AICT faculty development programs for keeping abreast of the development in various fields and make the students industry ready. ECE department has MOU with various industries such as AMD, Anant Technologies, Avantel Limited, TCS, Crane Software, ICOM Limited, etc. Department has MOU with various foreign universities like Missouri University, Bennett University, Oakland University, and so on. MOU with leading core companies and foreign universities have helped our ECE students in obtaining internship opportunities and placement offers and establishing advanced laboratories.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for letting us know that there are so many things which you are doing in collaboration with the industries. Since you have brought up this, that you are making the students industry ready, I would like to ask you just one more question. What are the kind of certified courses which you offer to your students in the branch of EC?
Certified courses bridge the gap between academics and industry needs. It helps to increase students' knowledge in their area of interest. And students have a choice to select their interested stream in doing certification courses in our department. Key outcomes for conducting certification courses in our department are: it helps students to obtain internships, provide opportunities to work on latest emerging technologies. Students can adapt to different curriculum for their higher studies. And this certification course duration is 40 to 60 hours, depending on the content. Few of the certification courses conducted in the department are Python, Internet of Things, FPGA tools, embedded systems, networking, etc. By conducting these certification courses, our ECE students gained knowledge in their interested field.
Thank you, Padmashree ma'am, for letting us know that these are the various courses that are being offered. Now I would like to come back to Kalyan, placement coordinator. Kalyan, can you just tell us what are the core jobs students from ECE can look up to? I mean, what are the main core placements, or how is the trend actually?
Okay, ma'am. Actually, we are getting core exclusively related to electronics and communication engineering related companies like Tata Elxsi, NCR. The NCR is making ATM machines, and Tata Communications, Synopsys, AMD processors. Next, TCS is hiring for TCS Digital, like they are working on artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning technologies. Exclude that, that package is different from apart from regular TCS. This is TCS Digital domain. Okay. Next, Socotronics. They are dealing with the semiconductor products. Next, Hyundai Mobis. Hyundai Mobis is dealing with the ECE students with respect to image processing techniques. Next, NTT Data. NTT Data is dealing with the optical fibers, optical communication. Veda IT. Veda IT is completely purely belongs to VLSI industry. Next, Oyatronics, Socotronics. Like that, we are a couple of companies, ma'am. So many companies we are having. Nearly we are having 15 plus core companies we are getting every year.
Right, sir. Right, sir. Thank you, sir. So it really gives a sense of excitement when they start working in a core domain. And it's very good to know that the ECE students are going into various core domain jobs also. Thank you. Now I'd like to get back to our industry expert, Mr. Avinash. Sir, I would like to know what is that the industry expects once a student passes out from ECE, and what are the main things that industry keeps looking for their job offers and all these things? Can you just tell us about that?
Yeah, sure, madam. So I think first is what anyone will look for is basically good academic performance. So if the student is academically consistent from his 10th intermediate and BTech, I think that is first what they will look at, because every company has a cutoff score, and I'm sure most of the students will be highly qualified from your institute. The other thing is obviously the fundamentals should be strong. When you are talking about ECE, obviously EDC, CMOS, VLSI, digital electronics, microprocessors. So these type of subjects, they should have very strong fundamentals. Obviously, the third thing that these days which we are looking for is industry ready, as Padmasai madam was mentioning. So making students industry ready is one of the challenges which every college is facing. And in fact, VNR Jyoti, VNR VJIT is actually exceeded in that angle that their students are or your students are actually industry ready right from their final year. So I think that is one very important aspect which every industry looks for, because once the fresher comes, it takes a long time for industry to train them. However, if the training happens in the college itself and they make them industry ready, it's easy for any industry to accept them. So I think industry training is very much required. I'm glad that, or I congratulate Padmasai madam for already doing that at all levels for both MTech, PG and UG students. So these are typically what we actually expect. So apart from all this, I think a good attitude will definitely help. If the student wants to learn, I think there is no limit for it. So obviously we would also be very happy to take people who are very eager to learn new things and new technologies. So this is pretty much what we look for.
Right, sir. Right. Thank you, sir. Thank you for letting us know about the various skill sets that are expected by the industry for these students coming out from ECE branch. Next, I would like to ask our alumnus Rajshekar sir. Rajshekar sir, I would like to ask you, how did you find the campus life? I mean, what was the things that you found interesting in VNR VJIT?
Yeah. So my campus life was very good. So that was the first time I got into Hyderabad for joining the college. So yeah, sometimes we used to bunk the classes and we used to have some time in the cafeteria. Apart from that, we used to have all kinds of events were placed in college. We used to have every year college fete will be there, and we used to have very good cultural programs, and we used to have the outdoor games like cricket and volleyball. Coming to the classes, I still remember Padmasai Madam class and Sri Hari sir class. Class I remember, Rajaratnam sir class I remember, who used to teach us electronic devices and circuits. So overall, college used to start from 9 to 4. We used to be very busy. We used to play indoor games, outdoor games, as well as we used to attend the labs for C programming and microprocessor and signals and system labs, EDC lab. So all these were very interesting. In fact, I enjoyed my stay in college for 4 years. It was a very great experience. And now recently I visited college, I think one and a half year back when I was going in that way, I visited the college. A lot of new buildings have come up and post-graduation has come up and MBA has come up. So I think definitely institute is taking high priority to develop the infrastructure. I think it is very good.
Right, sir. Right. Thank you. Now that I know that already I told you, and I can't help myself commenting that even you remember your teachers' names and the strong foundations that have been laid in the college. Very good to hear from you, from our alumnus like that. It really makes us feel happy at the end of the day that we could have given some impact to the students. Sir, just one more question. Now that you are in a position where you are leading certain team, so how was your graph? I mean, how was your career growth once you have left the college? How did you get to this point? So how has your education given you a kind of guidance in going in your career, sir?
Yeah. Okay. After I graduated, as I told, I started with a very small company where I have to do everything on my own. I have not joined a big MNC where a very big system I will be there. Lot of people will be there. Lot of processes will be there. So every person roles and responsibility will be defined. I started with a small company wherein I have to do everything on my own. Right from, as I told, the soldering, little bit PCB designing and coding, everything, testing. All those things I have learned in the beginning of my career. Then I joined an avionics company where I worked on the light combat aircraft, LCA aircraft I worked. So there it was a very short term. After that, I joined in the automobile industry in a company called Robert Bosch. So that has really helped me, especially the communication skills. Before joining into the Vignan Jyoti, my communication skills was a little bit weak. After joining into the Vignan Jyoti, 4 years studying there, my communication skills got improved. So that has really gave me a lot of strength and confidence to face the corporates. And in this process, I lived in Japan for 2 years. Then I came back. Then I worked in US for some time, almost 1 year. Then I came back to Hyderabad and I'm working for a Korean company now. I am heading a team of 40 people. So all the basics, whichever I've learned in my college and in my schooling, those basics are really helping me. That whatever the new technologies and the project needs and the demanding things which I have to continuously learn, but the basics are very good for me in the college. And Padmasai Madam, I would like to just tell you have shown Sai Krishna name in one of the slides. He and me work together. Right now he is in IIT Lucknow, I believe.
I am
Lucknow, yeah. See, he's a very good guy. After recruiting him, I used to tell to other team members also to proudly that he is from my college. He's a very bright student and still is in touch with me. He's a great student from Vignan Jyoti. Thank you for giving such students to the industry. Thank you, madam.
He's the gold medal from our department, sir.
Yeah. Just now, you have in the slide also, you have shown his photo. I've seen that photo. Sai Krishna, yes. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes.
He's a very bright student.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for telling us all these things. because it generally gives a strong authentication from an alumnus like you can clearly give our students guidance also telling that this is a very really very good option that they can explore. And since you have made a whatever achievements and all these things, I'd like to get back to Padmasai ma'am. Padmasai ma'am, can you just tell us something about your distinguished alumni who have been coming out from the department?
Sudha, can you see my slide?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So, really, we are very fortunate and happy to share that all our alumni, wherever they are going, whatever they are taking up. So because of them only, all our placements day by day, it is increasing. All our students, they are performing on par with IITs and NITs. I can proudly say that. So all recruiters, whenever they are visiting back and telling the same thing, we, as a teacher, we'll feel proud of that one. So recently, actually, Intel at USA, they have released 11th generation processor. In that, in the part of the team, our alumni is part. Vamshi is a part of that team. So really, as a teacher, we are more happy whenever our alumni is excelling. So Deepti Rawal, actually, Telangana government has taken initiation to start Women Hub. So she is leading. Actually, she pursued. I think she is Rajshekar. Is she your classmate?
Yeah, she is my classmate.
I remember 98, both of you are 98 batch. Actually, I started my career, I have experimented. First time I came here to teach, actually previously I am having only 1 year experience, even though I have industry experience. Okay, so she is leading all our alumni, wherever they are. Some they have started their own industry, some they are serving for various industries and holding prominent positions. And actually, it's because of them, not only they're leading their organization, they're giving a lot of guidance and mentoring to all their juniors. At present, whenever students are in campus, so whatever teachers we can teach, only academics we can teach. How industry is progressing, we should have a closed loop between industry and academia. So that loop is closed because of our alumni. I can thank all alumni. Because of that, our department is excelling very well.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. As you have rightly said, our VNR alumni, wherever they have been, they have always been very proactive in helping out or guiding their juniors in whatever capacity or whatever level they could. So it's really great to know about your alumni also. Ma'am, just one last question. So how do you ensure that your students have an all-round development once they come into your VNR Institute?
Okay, not only in academics. So I already mentioned about various hackathons conducted by now. Many recruiters, instead of conducting exam, they are conducting hackathons. That hackathon is not for VNR student. It is globally. The competition is among all the students across India. So in that, in such competitions also, our VNR students are competing with on par with IITs and NITs. So they brought many laurels to the department as well as the institute. Some of the laurels, so Deloitte, Technoso, and BITS competition, and best volunteer. So our not only academics, we encourage students to participate in professional activities also. So best volunteer award. And the Swiss hackathon that is conducted by Japan, that also backed by our students.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Any other extension activities which your students do apart from these things? I mean, apart from this academics and all these things, any other extension activities which you do for the society also?
We do. Actually, we are having two extension centers of NSS. Activities in college, VNR SF also there. So wherever necessary is there, our always our students are proactive. So when any in different situations in COVID time also, our institute also proactive, and they have given 40 lakhs to Telangana government. When Hudud Tufan happened at Vizag, our students have collected a lot of money, food grains, everything. They came, they collected, and they have distributed to needy persons. And Swachh Bharat, VNR supports Swachh Bharat. We actually supports orphans to write examination. So our students are weekends, they will go to blind schools and they will support them. And one more, so actually we are having one more differentiator. So that is actually what all our records, all our students, what they will do, they will recycle all the papers which are available in the campus. So all those books are distributed to all the school children who are pursuing their studies in government schools. All faculty and along with students will go to government schools and distribute all those books to the students. And not only that one, we actually now all of you are witnessing, because of COVID, everyone is talking about now. Whenever I am attending any programs, they are telling many students are going into depression. So at VNR, not only now in COVID situation, we also encourage students to practice all ancient practices. So we used to practice, we are having in-house yoga center is available in the campus. Yoga master also comes to college from 3 to 6, is available in the house, in-house, so that faculty members as well as student members are given yoga training. That is, as when they are joining in the institute first year itself, we expose all the students to go for yoga training. That is very much important to balance in whatever activity they are doing. They should balance their studies as well as their health, also very important. Even though they are having good education, without good health, we can't achieve whatever we want. And all activities, plantation, whenever Telangana government is calling for planting trees. So we used to actually previously, now because of road widening, so many trees they cut along our roadway. All those plants are planted by our team, our VNR team members. Now also, wherever, whenever we are having opportunity, we used to plant many plants. So that encourage our students also to do that.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, for letting us know that they have been part of the society and trying to giving it back in one or the other form. Next, I would like to get back to Padmashree ma'am with the last question. Ma'am, what are the various platforms which you give for the student to showcase their talent?
Starting from first year of ECE student, the students are exposed to various competitions to prove their ability, self-esteem, and leadership capabilities, are nurtured by motivating them to participate in various hackathons, project expos like open house, convergence, where students showcase their talent. ECE students emerged winners in Smart India hackathons organized by MHRD and AICTE at national level. Swish hackathon organized by Swish Foundation, Deloitte TechnoSU organized by Deloitte, JP Morgan contest code organized by JP Morgan, project contest organized by BITS Hyderabad. Like, our ECE students has participated in so many competitions, and they got winner prizes also. Our ECE students received winner prizes in various coding contests and hackathons.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for telling us that you give all the kinds of opportunities required for them to grow in an overall way. Next, coming to our placement coordinator, Kalyan. Kalyan, can you just tell us what are the significant placement records in this branch, and have the trainings offered to the placements obtained?
Okay, ma'am. As per the latest placement records of 2019 and 2020, I'm talking, madam, here. So, here in our VNR ECE department, more than 40% of students are settling with above 7 lakhs per annum packages, ma'am. Above 7 lakhs per annum packages. More than 40% of students. Okay. So, and we are getting high package companies, high package offered companies like JPMC with 14 lakhs per annum, Amazon 28 lakhs per annum, and Denso with 41.2 lakh per annum. And I would like to tell one record, that is, in last year, that means in 2020 batch, 2020 passed out batch, among whole VNR, 50 students were placed, were selected for Deloitte with an annual pay package of 7.6 lakhs per annum. Out of 50 students, 25 students are belongs to EC department only, madam. That was the record of Deloitte with respect to EC branch. Yes, ma'am. In this way, these are our placement, significant placement records.
Right, sir. Right, sir. Thank you. Thank you, Kalyan, for telling us about the placement and all this thing. Sir, coming back to Avinash, sir, can you tell us how you got to know, I mean, what was your involvement with VNR, and what do you think that, how do you think that VNR set is apart from the other institutes?
Yeah, so my first introduction to VNR was through Padmasai Madam at IEEE event. So so that is how I actually came in touch with her. But VNR Vignan Jyoti was a college which, so I was working earlier in Cyient Infotech Enterprises, and we go for a lot of campus interviews, and at that time actually I heard about VNR Vignan Jyoti. So one of the few institutes which actually gives core training. So we used to actually I remember, because I was not in the panel, but I remember that some of our HR people used to talk about VNR Vignan Jyoti. And I heard a lot about Padmasai Madam during those days, but I was very fortunate to meet her during an IEEE event. So now what is it that differentiates VNR from other colleges is, as I told you, the first thing is the ability or the hard work which Madam is putting in to reduce the gap between the industry and the academia. So I keep going to a lot of colleges to give guest lectures and conduct workshops, but the amount of work which is happening in VNR VJIT for the core jobs, especially I would like to mention that the work which is done for the core job is tremendous and really great. So I would like to congratulate her and all of you once again. Apart from that, the other things like what she is mentioning, right, to give back to the society, that is another thing which is not happening in other colleges as well. So I think just people are focusing on curriculum and just curricular activities, but these type of things, giving back to the society, doing something for the society, I think these are the things which actually distinguishes VNR from other colleges. And I really, from my heart, I would like to congratulate Padmasai Madam. I have heard a lot about her. I am very honestly speaking. I have heard a lot about her, but I never met her two, 3 years back when I met her at an IEEE event. After that, I have never lost in touch with her. I have been in continuous touch with her, and we hope to grow VNR take VNR to the next level. Thank you.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for those good words which you have given for our institute and for head of the department, Dr. Y. Padmasai, ma'am. One last question to Mr. Rajshekar before I wrap up this panel discussion. Rajshekar, sir, I would just like to know, how can EC students explore the various kinds of opportunities that lie ahead for them? So any suggestions on that point, actually?
Yeah. As Avinash mentioned, that any industry, when they take the fresh engineers from the colleges, they will look for the very basics. So once the basics are good, then they can establish the further things on that. So industry, like there were days when industry used to give a lot of training for the students, but now the whole industry is moving to the big data. Yeah, to analyze the big data, like millions of data, what are the different techniques are available? That we have to focus, and artificial intelligence, deep learning, machine learning. How do we make the machine? We will learn the machine to analyze the data more. So these four or five things which they need to focus from the first year of their engineering. What are the different kinds of machine learning algorithms? There are a lot of programs are coming, even if in Google, a lot of algorithms are there, but in their college, they need not to look into the Google, they need to refer the books actually. Different kinds of algorithms, what are the efficiencies, what are the trade-off conditions for those algorithms, for which industry, what are the different kind of proven algorithms. And as Padmasai madam is already involved in the IEEE papers, they need to go through the IEEE papers. These kind of learning, they have to start from at least second year of their academic. First year anyhow, it's a simple syllabus. From second year, the core subjects will start. This is one thing. Second thing is, if they want to go to the RF side, they have to be very strong in the signal side. If they have to go to the VLSI side, as Avinash said, they have to be very strong with the VHDL and SDL programming side. And if they want to go to an embedded system, they have to be very proven with the RTOS concepts and the operating systems, basics and the programming languages. And based on the satellite communication, there is a different stream, a lot of mobile communication, telecommunication, industries like medical industry is there, avionics is there, robotics is there. There are so many fields. Maybe after second year, they can choose, okay, I want to shine in this industry. This is my passion. Then they can make a way towards that.
Right, sir. Right, sir. Well said, sir. As you told, the basics should be very strong, as you have told. And I think VNR pretty much emphasizes mostly for the students also in this aspect. Thank you for giving those inputs. Thanks to all the panel members who have been part of this discussion. I would just like to throw open this panel discussion for the students and parents who might be interested in asking any questions to our panel members.
So before going for a question, we didn't talk about teaching learning process. Actually, that is also one of the best practices at VNR we follow. A blended learning happens through VNR differentiator like Wit and Will, POGIL, Lab Protocol, Storyboard, Uplift Classroom, etc., in catering to the students with various perception of learning. That is encouraged at VNR. That is very, very important. That is one point I want to add in addition to remaining thing, and project-based learning also. So at VNR, each and every lab, instead of evaluating experiment-based, we are evaluating lab through lab-based project. Each lab, they have to do one project. So we are encouraging students from first year onwards so that by the time they are going for fourth year placement, they should be able to tell about what they have done instead of seeing paper and telling orally, so they can do some experiments on what they have done. So that is also one of the unique feature at VNR we practice.
Right, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for letting us know about your teaching learning practices. So if there are any students or parents who would like to interact with the panel, they can do. The Spox will help them to pose the questions.
Ma'am, I'd like to ask a question to the placement coordinator.
Yes.
Yes.
So, sir, in which year can a student start their internship? And if they can start an internship, will the college help them in getting an internship in the college or out of the college?
Okay, Amma. Okay. Are you a student or parent?
Students. Maybe?
Okay. Okay. Very good question. Actually, we are most of the few of the companies are hiring students in the third year first semester itself, and 90% of the companies hiring students for internships during 4-1. Okay, after completion of first year, also in between first year to second year break, also you can go for internship, summer internships for 2 months or 3 months. Okay, and coming to paid internships, we are getting very good number of paid internship companies. That means the college is bringing good number of paid internship companies. Like Hyundai Mobis is offering 10,000 per month during fourth year first semester, and Blaze Automation is offering 10,000 per month. NCR is offering 25,000 per month during fourth year first semester. JPMC is the highest pay package offering for internship students, that means during fourth year first semester they are giving 50,000 per month, and ServiceNow is giving 20,000 per month, Amazon is offering 20,000 per month, DigiLogic is offering 10,000 per month, Islander is offering 10,000 per month, Synopsys is offering 15,000 per month. These are the whatever the companies I told right now, these are the companies who are offering a complete internship, 1 year internship during fourth year first semester onwards. Okay, and later that internship will be converted to a job. For example, JPMC is giving 50,000 per month for as an internship. Okay, after that in if you well performed in JPMC internship, then that will be converted into job with 14 lakh package. That means per month 1,10,000 rupees. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you,
sir. Okay.
Sir, if we take any EC branch now, are there any companies hiring students with a package of more than 10 lakhs?
Good question, Amma. You are asking very good question. Okay. We are getting Synopsys, and Synopsys is offering 10 lakhs per annum. Okay. Next, AMD. AMD is giving 12 lakhs per annum. Next, JPMC. JPMC is offering 14 lakhs per annum. Next, ServiceNow. ServiceNow is offering 18 lakhs per annum. Amazon is offering 25 lakhs per annum. Denso is offering 41.2 lakh per annum. Okay, almost more than 7 to 8 companies are offering about 10 lakhs packages for exclusively EC students. Okay, any doubts from students?
Sir, ippudu manam EC branch iskunte, are there any product based companies hiring students other than service based companies?
Very good question, Kamal. Excellent question. For just in an intermediate secondary itself, if you are asking like this question, that means the token word you used is product based companies. Yes, there is a lot of difference between product based companies and service based companies. Okay, coming to product based companies, like we are getting AMD means AMD is making microprocessors, motherboard chipsets, embedded processors, graphic processors for servers. Like these are the various products of AMD. Nuvu kuda chuse unto computers meeda AMD sticker chuse unto. Okay, and Hyundai Mobis. Hyundai is a car company name. Okay, Hyundai is exclusively recruiting ECE people with respect to image processing techniques. Okay, the entire car was designed by using image processing techniques. Okay, first itself for graphic design. Okay, next, National Cash Register, NCR company. Okay, NCR is making ATM machines, barcode scanners, check processing systems. Okay, and we are getting NCR company, and NCR company is offering 7.6 lakhs per annum. Okay, Avantel, all satellite products like satellite receivers, satellite transmitters, and satellite amplifiers, whatever the products related to satellite, those are prepared by Avantel, and we are getting Avantel company, and Avantel is offering 4.5 lakh per annum. Okay, next, NTT Data. NTT Data means Nippon Telegraph and Telephone Company. Okay, and this NTT Data deals with data communications, optical fiber, optical communications, robotics, robotic process automation. These are all parts of EC subjects only. Okay, next, we are getting Tata Elxsi. Tata Elxsi is a world's leading provider of design and technology services for product engineering, product prototyping, broadcast services, and especially communication products with the hardware design and implementation by using the concepts of analog communication and digital communication. And in association with the Tata Communications, they are doing many projects. Tata Communications means we are seeing Tata dishes. Okay, Tata dish antennas related to 4G and 5G networks. These are the couple of companies we are getting. These are all product based companies. Okay, okay, Kamal.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Good evening, sir. Good evening, madam.
Yes, sir.
I am from BHEL. I came to know more information related to EC branch, which are very useful for our children. Just previously, madam told about different certificate courses, and placements are also talked about. Artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, like that. Sir, we used to see about these courses in newspapers. How these courses are related to ECE branch? Can we have prospects in these domains if we join in ECE? If our children join in ECE, what ECE relation? Sir, we would like to know about this.
I think Padma Sai ma'am can answer this question.
Sir, actually now everyone is talking about machine learning and deep learning. So if you take ECE subject, okay, all those latest technologies are based on mathematics. If any student is good at math, they can take any subject with a lot of ease. And we are very fortunate. As ECE engineer, we are very fortunate. We are having from second year onwards, we are having subjects from signals and systems. Now everybody is telling about machine learning, mean square error, the all those algorithms. So now if you look into it, all those algorithms, all our students are studying in signals and systems, DSP, advanced DSP, VLSI algorithms, all those things part and parcels of ECE. But we didn't coin that time AI and machine learning. Actually, we are having neural networks and neural networks from 2000 onwards, we are having part and parcel of our content, our syllabus, course. But now they are telling deep learning. Deep learning also part of neural network only. So at the time, because of processor capability is less, so we are having hidden layers, one or two layers. But now that also everybody should thank to ECE department, because of high-end processors are available. Because of that, all these advancement in technology came into existence. So in deep learning, only main difference between neural network and deep learning is, in deep learning, you're having various n number of layers. So based on your application, number of layers are increasing. That is only difference. Actually, we are all ECE engineers. We are studying all these things before now coining these words, AI and machine learning and deep learning. Okay, I can happily say that. So if our students are good at all fundamentals of all subjects, already Rajashekar mentioned about all those things. When they are in the campus, they should learn without leaving any subject, whether it may be mathematics, whether it may be English, whether it may be EDC or whatever, whatnot. If they are learning thoroughly, so then when they are leaving VNR, they don't have any problem. Whatever technology it is coming, they don't have any problem. They can excel very well.
Thank you.
Hello, madam. Hello.
Yeah,
good evening, madam. నేను పేరెంట్ మాట్లాడుతున్నాను మేడం.
చెప్పండి
మేడం. మా అబ్బాయిని ఈసీలో జాయిన్ చేయాలంటే యాక్చువల్గా కొంత ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ మేడం. కోర్ రిలేటెడ్ గవర్నమెంట్ జాబ్స్ ఏముంటాయి అనేది డౌట్ ఉంది మేడం. కోర్ రిలేటెడ్ గవర్నమెంట్ జాబ్స్.
కళ్యాణ్, కెన్ యూ ఆన్సర్ దిస్ క్వశ్చన్?
మేడం, so many companies are offering that means for ECE students, they are offering very good number of core jobs. Like for example, meer space research center iskunte ISRO, next Vikram Sarabhai space research center, next NRSC national remote sensing center, next NARL national atmospheric research laboratory, next IITM Pune Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, next MTRDC micro tube research development center, next defense laboratories like DRDL, DRDO, RCA. Okay, మొత్తం ఇవన్నీ కూడా మీ కోర్ రిలేటెడ్ మేడం. నెక్స్ట్ ఈసీఎల్ ఈజ్ బల్క్ హైరింగ్ ఇస్ దేర్ ఫర్ ఈసీఎల్ ఫర్ ఈసీ స్టూడెంట్స్. ఈసీఎల్ కంపెనీ మన సికింద్రాబాద్ లో ఉంది కదా మేడం, ఈసీఎల్ చాలా బల్క్ రిక్రూట్మెంట్ ఉంది. నెక్స్ట్ బిహెచ్ఎల్ సరే అలాగే ఫ్యూ నవరత్న అండ్ మహారత్న కంపెనీస్ ఆర్ దేర్. నేను చెప్పిన ఒక 50% చెప్పాను, ఇంకా చాలా కంపెనీస్ ఉన్నాయి మీకు.
ఓకే సార్, థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
ఓకే మ్యామ్. ఓకే మ్యామ్.
ఓకే సార్.
ఓకే మ్యామ్.
So any other doubts? Can someone check the chat box, Spox, if there are any questions which can be put up?
Hello. నమస్కారం అండి. యాక్చువల్లీ నాకు ఒక డౌట్ ఉందండి, దాని గురించి అడగాలి. మా బాబు యాక్చువల్లీ ఐజీసీఎస్ఈ కరికులం లో చదువుతున్నాడండి. జనరల్ గా తన ప్లాన్ ఏంటి అని అంటే బ్యాచులర్స్ కి యుఎస్ పంపుదాము అని ప్లాన్. కానీ ఈ సిట్యువేషన్ లో నేను అక్కడికి పంపించడానికి కూడా ఆలోచిస్తున్నాను. సో ఇప్పుడు అలాంటి ఐజీసీఎస్ఈ కరికులం లో చదివే పిల్లలు మీ దగ్గర ఎవరైనా జాయిన్ అయ్యారా అండి ఆల్రెడీ?
ఏ కరికులంలో చదివామా అని కాదమ్మా, ఫండమెంటల్స్ స్కూల్లో బాగా నేర్చుకుంటే యాక్చువల్గా నాకు తెలిసిన వరకు ఆ కరికులము కాన్సెప్ట్ బాగా నేర్పిస్తారు. దాని వలన మీ పిల్లడు ఇక్కడ చేరినా కూడా అంత కష్టమేమి ఉండదు. సో డెఫినెట్లీ హీ విల్ తను ఈ సిలబస్ కి ట్యూన్ చేస్తాము. ఏదైనా అవసరం అయితే మీ స్పెషల్ కేర్ తీసుకొని ట్రైనింగ్ ఇస్తాం బాబుకి.
ఇలాంటి పిల్లలకి మీరు ఏమన్నా స్పెషల్ గా వేరే క్లాసెస్ ఏమైనా కండక్ట్ చేస్తారా అండి? మామూలుగా ఇప్పుడు ఫండమెంటల్స్ ఏమైనా ల్యాక్ అవుతే గనక అలాంటి పిల్లల కోసం ఏమైనా స్పెషల్ గా క్లాసులు ఏమైనా తీసుకుంటారా?
ఎస్ మేడం, మాకు ట్యూటోరియల్ అవర్స్ ఉంటాయి మేడం. ఎవ్రీ డే వీక్లీ 4 ట్యూటోరియల్ అవర్స్ ఉంటాయి. ఈ ట్యూటోరియల్ అవర్స్ లో ఒకవేళ కనుక వాళ్ళు ట్యూన్అప్ అవ్వకపోతే, గేరప్ అవ్వకపోతే వాళ్ళకి ఎక్స్ట్రా క్లాసులు ఖచ్చితంగా తీసుకుంటారు మేడం. అది టైం టేబుల్ లోనే ఫిక్స్ చేసి ఉంటాయి దోస్ ట్యూటోరియల్ అవర్స్.
ఓకే, అంటే అందరికి కలిపి ఉంటుంది కదండి సార్? మీరు చెప్పిన దాని ప్రకారము ఒట్టి సపరేట్ గా ఇలాంటి కరికులం ఉన్న వాళ్ళకి అలాగే ఏమైనా స్పెషల్ కేర్ అనేది ఏమైనా
అంటే వాళ్ళ కనుక మేము పెట్టే టెస్ట్ లో కానీ లేకపోతే క్లాస్ లో కానీ లాగ్ అవుతున్నట్టు అనిపిస్తే డెఫినెట్ లో వాళ్ళందరినీ కూడా మనం సెపరేట్ బ్యాచ్ చేసి ఎక్స్ట్రా ట్రైనింగ్స్ ఈవినింగ్ టైమ్ ప్రొవైడ్ చేస్తాం మేడం. అండ్ వాళ్ళకి ఫ్యాకల్టీ కూడా టైప్ చేస్తాం, వాళ్ళకి పర్సనల్ మానిటరింగ్ కూడా వాళ్ళకి చాలా ఉంటుందండి.
అదే ఒకవేళ అంటే ఇప్పుడు మామూలుగా మేము ప్లాన్ చేసుకుంది బ్యాచిలర్స్ కి పంపిద్దామని కదండి. ఇప్పుడు బ్యాచిలర్స్ కి పంపించలేకపోతున్నాం కాబట్టి మాస్టర్స్ కి వెళ్ళటానికి కూడా మీరు ప్లేస్మెంట్స్ గురించి చాలా బాగా చెప్పారండి. అంటే బాగున్నాయి వినటానికి కూడా, అన్ని పెద్ద పెద్ద నంబర్స్ తో బాగున్నాయి. ఇప్పుడు సపోజ్ నేను తన్ని ఎక్కడన్నా వేరే చోటకి మాస్టర్స్ కి పంపించాలి అని అనుకుంటే మంచి మంచి యూనివర్సిటీస్ కి మీకు మీతో ఏమైనా కొలాబరేషన్ ఉందా వేరే యూనివర్సిటీస్ కి ఏమైనా?
ఉన్నాయి మేడం, ఉన్నాయి మేడం.
ఉన్నాయండి. అది కాకుండా మేము పిల్లలకి ఆల్రెడీ మా అల్యూమిని వేరియస్ యూనివర్సిటీల్లో ఉన్నారు, మేము ఇక్కడ కూడా గైడెన్స్ ఇస్తాము పిల్లలకి. సో ఏ వాళ్ళ ప్యాషన్ తగ్గట్టు ఇక్కడ కేర్ తీసుకొని ఏ యూనివర్సిటీకి వెళ్ళాలనుకుంటే ఏ ఏరియా వేరే సిగ్నల్ ప్రాసెసింగ్ వెళ్ళారా విఎల్ఎస్ఐ ఫీల్డ్ తగ్గట్టు మేము ట్రైనింగ్ ఇస్తామండి. సో వీ ఆల్సో ఎంకరేజ్ దెమ్ టు టేక్ జిఆర్ఇ టోఫిల్ అది కోచింగ్ తీసుకోవాలి, అవి తీసుకున్న తర్వాత ఎంఎస్కి వెళ్ళొచ్చండి.
ఓకే,
చాలా మంది పిల్లలు వెళ్తూనే ఉన్నారండి.
మీ దగ్గర కోచింగ్స్ జిఆర్ఇ టోఫిల్ అంటే మీరు చెప్పిన దాని ప్రకారం గేట్ కి ఎలాగో కోచింగ్ ఇస్తున్నారు మీ ఫ్యాకల్టీతో అని చెప్పి విన్నామండి. అలాగే జిఆర్ఇ టోఫిల్ కి కూడా ఏమైనా స్పెషల్ గా ఉంటుందా ఈ అకాడమిక్ తో పాటు?
మేము యాక్చువల్ గా బయట వాళ్ళతో కొలాబరేట్ అయ్యి వాళ్ళు ఇన్ హౌస్ వచ్చి ట్రైనింగ్ ఇస్తారండి.
ఓకే,
టైమ్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూట్
మాకు మాన్హాటన్ తో అసోసియేషన్షిప్ ఉంది మేడం. మాన్హాటన్ మీకు వినే ఉంటారు, ఇది జిఆర్ఇ ట్రైనింగ్
ఫేమస్. అవునండి, అవునండి.
మాన్హాటన్ ఇస్ కమింగ్ అండ్ దేర్ ఆల్సో టేకింగ్ క్లాసెస్ మ్యామ్. ఓకే, సో అండ్ మాకు లాస్ట్ ఇయర్ రికార్డ్స్ చూసుకుంటే మోర్ దెన్ 330 అంటే ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ 326 టు 326 అంటే ఇట్స్ ఏ పీక్ స్కోర్ జిఆర్ఇ లో. ఓకే, సో 326 ప్లస్ వచ్చిన వాళ్ళు మా దగ్గర 14 స్టూడెంట్స్ ఉన్నారండి. 326 ప్లస్ వచ్చిన వాళ్ళు జిఆర్ఇ స్కోర్.
ఇంకొకటి అడ్మిషన్స్ కోసం వచ్చినప్పుడు ఏదో యూనివర్సిటీ ఆఫ్ టెక్సాస్ తో టైఅప్ అయ్యాము అని చెప్పి విన్నాం సార్, అది దేని మీద టైఅప్ అయి ఉన్నారు సార్? ఇంటర్న్షిప్స్ రిలేటెడా?
ఇంటర్న్షిప్ కాదు, ఇప్పుడు సమ్మర్ బ్రేక్ ఉన్నప్పుడు ఇంటర్న్షిప్ వెళ్ళొచ్చు, పీజీ ప్రోగ్రామ్ వెళ్ళినప్పుడు కూడా. సో అప్పుడు కన్సిడర్ చేస్తామని విఎన్ఆర్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ని ఫోర్త్ ఇయర్ అక్కడికి వెళ్ళి 1 ఇయర్ అక్కడ చదివితే విత్ ఇన్ 5 ఇయర్స్ దే విల్ గివ్ బీటెక్ డిగ్రీ యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ఎంఎస్ డిగ్రీ. బీటెక్ డిగ్రీ ఫ్రమ్ విఎన్ఆర్, ఎంఎస్ డిగ్రీ ఫ్రమ్ టెక్సాస్.
ఈ ప్రొవిజన్ మన ఈసీ బ్రాంచ్ కి ఉందా మేడం?
అది కాలేజీ మొత్తం కి ఉందండి.
ఓకే,
సో పిల్లల ఇంట్రెస్ట్ బట్టి హూఎవర్ ఇస్ ఏబుల్, పిల్లలు ఎవరైతే డబ్బులు కట్టగలరో పేరెంట్స్ వాళ్ళు దాన్ని ప్రిఫర్ చేస్తున్నారండి.
థ్యాంక్ యూ మేడం, థ్యాంక్ యూ సో మచ్ అండి.
ఓకే, సో దేర్ ఆర్ సమ్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఇన్ ద చాట్ బాక్స్ విచ్ ఐ కెన్ సీ. డిజిటల్ డొమైన్, ఎనలాగ్ డొమైన్, డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ డిజిటల్ డొమైన్ అండ్ ఎనలాగ్ డొమైన్, దట్ వాస్ వన్ క్వశ్చన్ విచ్ హెస్ బిన్ పోస్ బై ద స్టూడెంట్. ఐ థింక్ యూ విల్ గెట్ ఎ నో ఆఫ్ ఇట్ వన్స్ యూ గెట్ ఇట్ టు ద స్ట్రీమ్ ఆర్ గెట్ ఇన్ టు ద బ్రాంచ్ వేర్ ఇన్ వీ కీప్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ ఆల్ దీస్ సబ్జెక్ట్స్. ఐ థింక్ ఎట్ దిస్ లెవెల్ ప్రాబ్లీ యూ మే నాట్ బి ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ఇట్ మోర్ ప్రిసైజ్లీ. This is just what you call a terminology which we keep associated with some of the subjects. And what does core job mean? Yeah, core job means that it only means that whatever branch you have studied, like suppose if you are taking a PCE, So are you doing any job relevant to ECE related subjects, or is it that you are going into some kind of software job or something like that? Core job means you are working in your domain itself wherein you have studied. So I think those are the questions. Apart from that, other questions have been answered. And as I see, most of them are interested in the placements aspect, I think. And I can definitely understand the parents' concerns related to the placements, because that is what they are looking at finally. Thank you for all the audience, those who have joined us. And thank you all the panel members, Padma Sai ma'am, Padma Shri ma'am, Kalyan, Avinash sir, and Rashekar sir for being part of this panel discussion. It really gave us a lot of insight, and probably the students also will be hearing you out once they look into this panel discussion. They'll be able to get an idea of how to branch, especially if they are looking in with interest in this easy branch. Thank you, sir. Thank you for all the people who have joined.
So that I want to add one point.
Yes, ma'am.
Finally, I request all the parents not to force their kids to take a particular branch of your choice, your wish. Give them the chance to choose their stream with their interest only. So I request all the parents. So most of the case when the students are joining and when I am interacting with them, they used to tell to all the faculty members as well as to me. So this is my sincere advice to all the parents. Please don't force them. So please enlighten them, enlighten and educate them. What is the importance and all those things? But we should not force them and to take this branch. This is, even though already all members mentioned, so Ravinash mentioned about the statistics. Okay, so even the software job, initially you are getting large, huge salary, but as the days are going up, core job, core whoever is working for core ECE jobs, their salary is exceedingly high compared to software professional. I can assure all of you. This is my message to all the parents. So please don't influence your ward.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you for that thing. Yeah, any branch taken up with passion. Yeah, Kalyan.
I would like to tell one example, madam. Actually 2 years, 3 year, 2.5 years, 3 years back, I think 2017 passed out anukuntanu, man daggara oka student, he shortlisted for ECE, sorry, TCS company. Okay, appudu 3.3 they offered a package, athaniki inka manchi company lu raledu, only 3.3 vachindi, chaala upset ayyadu, aina sare join ayyadu. Aithe TCS lo chaala vigorous ga work chesadu, vigorous ga work chesi అతను టెలికామ్ డొమైన్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ లో పడ్డాడు, నోకియా ప్రొడక్ట్ లో, నోకియా ప్రాజెక్ట్ లో ఒక దాంట్లో ఉన్నాడు. తర్వాత టెలికామ్ డొమైన్ రిలేటెడ్ ప్రాజెక్ట్స్ ఇంకో దాంట్లో కూడా క్యారీ అయ్యాడు. అతను క్యారీ అయిన తర్వాత 2 ఇయర్స్, జస్ట్ 2 ఇయర్స్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్స్ తో హీ వెంట్ ఫర్ ఎ సిస్కో ఇంటర్వ్యూ. అండ్ వన్ థింగ్ హ్యాపెన్ ఇన్ సిస్కో ఇంటర్వ్యూ. ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీషన్ ఆఫ్ దట్ సిస్కో ఇంటర్వ్యూ, దట్ మేనేజర్ ఆస్క్డ్ దట్ గై హౌ మచ్ యు ఆర్ ఎక్స్పెక్టింగ్ ప్యాకేజ్. అండ్ దిస్ గై సెడ్ దట్ సార్ 8 లాక్స్ తక్కువ వస్తే నేను చేయను అని చెప్పేసి చెప్పాడు. చెప్తే వాళ్ళు రివర్స్ లో ఏం ఆఫర్ చేశారంటే, వీఆర్ ఆఫరింగ్ 14 లాక్స్ ఫర్ యూ అని చెప్పేసి రివర్స్ లో ఇచ్చేప్పటికి, సో చాలా అతను షాక్ అయ్యాడు అనమాట. సో దట్ మీన్స్ మనం కరెక్ట్ గా యూటిలైజ్ చేసుకుంటే షార్ట్ స్పాన్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ లోనే, బికాస్ సిస్కో ఈస్ కంప్లీట్లీ డీలింగ్ విత్ నెట్వర్కింగ్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్. ఓకే, ద అండ్ ఆల్ 4G నెట్వర్క్స్, 5G నెట్వర్క్స్ కంప్లీట్లీ దీస్ ఆర్ బిలాంగ్స్ టు సమ్ సిస్కో రిలేటెడ్ కంపెనీస్ ప్రొడక్ట్స్. సో వాళ్ళకి అతనికి చాలా, అది చాలా ప్లస్ అయింది మేడం. సో లైక్ దట్.
Thank you Kalyan for giving that example also. Thanks to all the panel members. Thanks, and I think we have addressed most of the queries even through the chat box. Thank you one and all, and thanks for the team for putting the efforts for conducting.
Thank you Rashekar, Avinash, and thanks Sudha for taking care of organizing this event.
Thank you all. Thank you,
thank you.
Thank you so much.
See all of you.